So, this is a video that I feel like has needed to be made for quite some time, but a lot of people are afraid to, you know, give any positive thoughts on, Umbrella Corpse, just because they don't want to deal with, you know, the nostalgia nerd rage. See, the benefit of me being a smaller channel is I can say what I want to and not give a fuck about losing subscribers or any of that business. So, I'm gonna tell you how I feel. If you don't like it, fuck you. I don't care. So, first off, let me make this as blatant as it, and as frank as I can. Stop fucking whining about Umbrella Corpse. Like, do you guys, like, there's a good portion of people who, you know, enjoy what this game is trying to do. It's a spinoff. It's trying to do something different. It's not a main part of the series. I can understand if you were whining about the fact that, you know, it went from 1 to 2, 1 through 3, to 4 through 6, to suddenly being a tactical shooter in Resident Evil 7. But it's a spinoff, dude. Let me look up what spinoff is, because a lot of people seem to be confused and have no clue why they're even whining. Okay, so spinoff. Noun, a byproduct or incidental result of a larger product. Now, what does this mean? It means that it's not a main entry in the series. It's not Resident Evil 7. It's not trying to be Resident Evil 7. It was never marketed as Resident Evil 7. It's just a tactical shooter. It's a spinoff. Now, granted, okay, nostalgia nerds are going to be nostalgia nerds that just can't accept that games are trying to do something different and that they're not the same and all that good stuff. But, oh my god, like, have you seen the amount of whining over the internet over the fact that this isn't, you know, scary? It's not supposed to be scary, you moron. It was never supposed to be scary. And this happens with, you know, every series. There's always that group of people that just cannot accept that it's not how it is when it first started. Just nostalgia nerds out the ass just for no reason. Oh my god, it's not scary anymore. You're just gonna have to come to terms with the fact that Resident Evil is not scary anymore. It was only scary to people who first experienced it in maybe 1998. Yeah, that's when the first game came out. Or it might have been 1997. Either way, it was only scary to people who played it around that time. Everybody else, a lot of people, if you remember correctly, a lot of people wanted nothing to do with Resident Evil just because of the way it played. It was not a very fun game to some people. There was a lot of praise for it. There were a lot of people who enjoyed it. A lot of people in that niche community that enjoyed it. But it was not a main stellar success, you know, everybody wanted to play it, everybody wanted to have it type of thing. It was not. And whether you want to accept it or not, Resident Evil changing to an action shooter is probably the best thing to happen to the series from a business standpoint, at least. Because I can tell you right now, the sales that these games make now, Capcom could have never dreamed of making if they would have stayed on the path they were staying on with Resident Evil 1, 2, 3, and Code Veronica. And Zero, if you want to count Zero, even though I can't stand Zero. But yeah, so that's just brutal honesty. And if you don't like it, oh well. I mean, you can dislike the video if you want. I don't give a shit. I don't have any incentive. Like, you don't hurt my feelings when you, you know, dislike a video. You don't. So yeah, whether you fucking nostalgia survival horror fans want to admit it or not, you're not the only people with opinions that count. You're not. Capcom does not only care about your opinions. It cares about the people that enjoy the games that it makes. Like, these are real people with real jobs, real lives, real families to go home to that work their asses off to try to make these games for you guys. and all you ever do. Like, Capcom has got to have one of the worst fan bases I think I've ever seen, been a part of, ever, you know, even experienced in my life. Like, you can give Call of Duty as much crap as you want to. You can give Five Nights at Freddy's fans as much crap as you want to. Nothing compares to the retarded fan base that Capcom seems to have. So first off, let's talk about what Umbrella Corps is, okay? It's a tactical shooter that can be played in both the first and third persons. You know what that means, right? Every nostalgia nerd on the planet is going to compare it to Call of Duty, even though Call of Duty can't be played in the third person. But because they hear the word tactical shooter, suddenly, it's trying to be Call of Duty. When it's really not. Like, for example, Call of Duty is a more fast-paced, you know, in-your-face kind of run and gun, blow up everything you can type of thing. Resident Evil Umbrella Corps is more of a slow-paced tactical shooter where your decisions have to matter. It's more in line with something like Counter-Strike with zombies in it, which I think is a really cool concept. But of course, because it's not scary, people are gonna fucking cry about it, like they always do. I gotta give props to Capcom, because I know a lot of developers want to tell, you know, whiny fans that just can't accept that they're not gonna feel, no game is gonna make them feel the way that it used to make them feel when they first played the first line in the series, and that do absolutely nothing but whine about the fact that some things have changed in order to keep the series moving forward. Like, I know a lot of developers who just want to tell those kinds of people to just, you know, eat shit. I don't need you. I can find, you know, newer fans somewhere else that aren't gonna gripe and moan about everything. But, you know, they have some restraint, and I respect that. I respect them for doing what they want to do, as opposed to what their whiny-ass nostalgia fans tell them that they should be doing. If you remember correctly, Resident Evil 1, the little GameCube remake of the first game, that didn't sell very well when it first came out. It didn't. It sold well almost over 10 years down the line is when it finally, you know, hit a decent sales rate with its re-release that made Capcom think, oh, okay, we might actually be able to market these remasters. But I'm sorry to burst your bubble. You can cry little bitch tears at me, dislike my video if you want to, I don't care. But they're never, I repeat, they're never, never going to make the Resident Evil games the way they used to, with the fixed camera angles and the limited save slots and all that business. It's not gonna happen. You know why? Because most people aren't gonna buy it. They're not. You like, I don't know what it is about survival horror fans that think because they have such a small, compact, you know, bandwagon of hate, that they think they're suddenly in the majority, but they're not. Let me burst your bubble for a minute. As terrible as you guys, you specific group of people, might think that Resident Evil 6 is, the game is the second best-selling game Capcom has ever made. You can say it sold off of hype, but then you guys bitched about Resident Evil 5 too, didn't you? Which, by the way, is Capcom's best-selling game ever of any game they've ever made of any series in their line. Best-selling game. You guys bitched about that, didn't you? So then Resident Evil 6 came out. You already knew what to expect. Everybody played the demos. So why do you think it sold so well? Because whether you want to admit it or not, just because you hear some hate for it on the internet, doesn't mean the average gamer, who, by the way, doesn't really do this whole internet opinion thing, actually enjoyed the game. Bought it, loved it. Either kept it when they were done with it, or sold it when they were done with it. That's just how gaming works. But no, you're not in the majority, whether you want to admit it or not. So, believe it or not, you're not the only opinion that counts. There are, I mean, you have your survival horror fans that like Resident Evil for its survival horror aspect, and then you have people like me that, you know, just like the series in general, just like it because it's fun to play. And the action shooter, the action horror type of games, such as 4, 5, and 6, are just more fun for me to play. I love the whole third person action. Like, Resident Evil has a signature style that's of its own. And I love the games just because I love Resident Evil. That's just the type of gamer I am. I'm not a very picky gamer, if you guys can tell by any of my walkthroughs. Like, I'll play a game that some people didn't like, or it has a little hate wagon for it on the internet, and I'll be like, you know what, I enjoyed it. That's all that fucking matters to me. I enjoyed it. So, I made this video just because I was so sick of everybody always whining about this game. I don't understand what all the whining is about. Well, granted, some things can be done a bit better, and I'm in no way calling this a perfect game. Like, it really needs some polish. For example, the animations are absolutely ridiculous. They're just so bad. They're really, really bad. But this game has a lot of potential going for it. For example, the little shield thing, it's sort of a trade-off. First off, it's more, you know, tactical. Like, you can't just go in there, blast everything to bits, and expect to win. It's not gonna go down like that. You're gonna get your shit rocked. But, for example, the little shield thing, basically how that works is, if your gun is big, you can't use your shield. If you're using your pistol or your little melee, what is it, like a pickaxe that just fucks people up? If you're using something like that, you can put your little arm guard up and it'll protect you from headshot damage. And it'll make you harder to kill. And you know what's cool about that is that if a zombie bites it, you can use them as a human shield to help you get, you know, close in some distance on whoever's shooting at you. And the zombie will take the damage. You can get in real close and, you know, beat that ass with your melee attack. Like, what is it with Resident Evil fans? And it's not even Resident Evil fans. It's Resident Evil, you know, nostalgia fags. It's Resident Evil nostalgia nerds that just cannot fucking accept that it's, you know, it's not what it used to be. Because a fan of a series is going to accept that certain parts of it, certain things might be done a bit different. Those things might not be done for you, but you don't have to play it. If you want something like Resident Evil 1 through 3, just go play 1 through 3 again. It's not hard. If you want something like Resident Evil 4, 5, and 6 again, go play those games again. It's not hard. That's what I do all the time when I want to play something like those games. I go play those games. But if Resident Evil 7 came out, like, if Resident Evil 7 got announced a month from now, and it was not like Resident Evil 6, it wasn't like Resident Evil 2, it went in, you know, it tried to do something different, I'd accept that it did something different. Why? Because I have an open mind. I'm not a closed-minded gamer. And I think that's the problem with a lot of Resident Evil fans, is that they're closed-minded and they're self-entitled, and they think that, you know, everything that isn't what they specifically want is always marketed towards a casual gamer, as if having a life outside of video games and not just playing video games all the time is something that's, you know, a negative aspect, as if sitting around playing, you know, video games all day is, you know, the most positive, productive thing you can do. And it's always that specific, closed-minded type. Like, I cannot stand, this whole point of me making this video, I cannot stand a closed-minded gamer. I just can't. Like, you shut yourself out of so much enjoyable, so many different types of games by being closed-minded. I mean, you can try something. If you don't like it, you don't like it. But to just straight up, you know, bash on something just because it's different, just because it's not what you're used to, just because it's not what you thought you would want, it's not what you think of when you think of whatever it is you like about something, is stupid. You would never... Like, imagine trying to get somebody into video games who, you know, it's not what they're used to, it's not what they want, it's not their usual form of entertainment, and they just keep telling you, oh, no, this isn't what I'm used to, I don't want anything to do with it. It would be like, what the fuck, just try it. If you don't like it, you don't like it. If you do like it, that's great, you like it. And that's basically what Capcom is getting at. They don't want, like, these are real people, they want to do different things, they don't want to just keep releasing the same, they never wanted to, like, you're gonna have to remember that Resident Evil, a lot of people were saying it was going stale before Resident Evil 4 came out. People were bored with it, they wanted nothing to do with it. They tried a game or two, okay, it was nice, they tried another one, okay, I'm getting kind of tired of it. It's time to play something else. Resident Evil was losing its traction. It was losing its appeal to people because people were moving on to modern games and games that weren't as restrictive and clunky to play with. The original Resident Evils inspired an entire survival horror genre. It inspired an entire genre. And Resident Evil 4 through 6 inspired an entire genre. No matter what you may think about these games, they're always going to be influential. Whether you're a part of the series or not, whether you want to accept the changes or not, the series is going to keep moving forward without you because it's always going to find new people to appeal to. New people to give it a try, new people to like it, dislike it, whatever. But I'm so sick of all the damn whining. Like, have you seen the videos, the video ratio? Like, the like to dislike on the latest stuff, it's just ridiculous. Just nothing, like, and you can tell it's nothing but, you know, whiny ass nostalgia nerds that just couldn't accept changes. They just find it. They wait for Capcom to upload something new about this game so they can, you know, negative bomb this game. The same way it works with Steam reviews and how Doom got that, negative Steam review bomb where people were just like, oh, I don't like it. Oh, he doesn't like it. So that means let me find something negative to think about the game so I can say I don't like it. And I can be, you know, part of the loud crowd. And it was just fucking learn to accept change. If you don't like Umbrella Corps, if you give it a try and you don't like it, that's fine. You don't like it. But know that the Resident Evil series has a wide market to appeal to. It has survival horror fans to appeal to. It has action shooter fans to appeal to. That's what was so great about Resident Evil 6, despite the fact that a lot of people disliked it, a lot of people did like it. And what was great about that is that it had a whole bunch of different types of gamers that it tried to appeal to. And I really dug that. That was a very, very ambitious type of thing to do. And I've never seen another game attempt it on that scale, where it had like three different campaigns, well, four if you count Ada's, but three different campaigns that played three different ways. You're just going to have to accept that survival horror fans aren't the only fans of Resident Evil. Resident Evil has action shooter fans. This is something really unique and special, and it could really be something different that we haven't seen on the market before. So give it a chance. I hope I've changed, you know, somebody's viewpoints. Because when I originally started making this video, I was very angry over the fact that people were, you know, just whining and whining and whining. And it's still fucking pathetic to me. It really is that some people are just so negative. They're never satisfied. Like, they gave you zombies back. You were like, oh my god, we wanted zombies back. We want zombies back. So they gave you zombies back. And you were like, oh my god, why'd you give us zombies back? Blah, 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 blah. Like, some people are never satisfied. The gaming community does not know what it wants. It just doesn't. So, more power to developers that, you know, just do what the fuck they want to do. Do what they artistically, you know, envision, and more power to, you know, the more power to the gamers that can accept change, can, you know, try something new and think for themselves and determine whether or not they like or dislike something for themselves, instead of just banding together like a bunch of fucking morons that do nothing but complain about the fact that it isn't like it used to be, or hey, wah, this doesn't give me the same feeling that the first game gave me. Wah, this isn't the same, this doesn't give me the same feeling that a game that came out over 10 years ago gave me. Now, that's not to say the game is all, it's all positive, because it's not. I see some things that really, you know, that really are like, yeah. Like, for one, the animation. For two, the little zombie tracker thing. I'm not the biggest fan of that one, either. Just because I feel like zombies should be a bigger threat. Like, it would be really cool if you had to both deal with the zombies and AI characters, the human characters. You had to kind of, you know, keep them under control while you tried to battle the human characters, but maybe that's a bit too much. I want to see how this plays, and while I do have my own ideas, as you can see, I do have my own ideas as to what I'd want more out of this game, I'm willing to try it. At first, you know, I was a bit off put by it too. I was like, you know, what is this? Like, it's even drastic from what it was from 6. 6 is my favorite Resident Evil game, and this one is a bit, it's a hell of a lot different from that. But I understand that it's a spinoff. I was the same way about the Devil May Cry reboot, and I've been the same way about other games. But over time, like, it was just an initial reaction. It's like, what is this? This is a bit different. Then you get over it, and you're like, oh, okay. It's a bit different. Let me stop being a little bitch and try it. Think for myself and determine whether or not I like it or I don't like it. That's really just all I have to say about it is, you know, think for yourself. Don't just jump on a hate wagon. I see this a lot. I see a lot of people just jump on an internet hate wagon for a game who haven't even played it. Say negative things about it because they hear other people saying negative things about it, and it's just pathetic to me. But, you know, keep an open mind with this game. It's not a main entry in the series. It's a spinoff. And whether you want to accept it or not, there is a market for it. There are people who are going to buy it. There are people who are going to like it. And you can call them casual gamers and little kids all you want to, but that doesn't make you sound any less fucking stupid. I mean, first off, let's talk about that. I hear this argument a lot. The only people that like the game I don't like are kids. You have no idea how stupid you sound when you say that. First off, kids can't even buy the game. It's rated M for mature. They would have to have their parents buy it. And even then, no parent in their right mind is going to go out and spend money on every game that you don't like, so you can have a reason to say, oh, this sold well because kids liked it. Umbrella Corps is not a horror game. Get the fuck over it. Resident Evil has two different audiences to appeal to, and it's one of the most popular franchises that have ever existed. You're just going to have to deal with that. Get the fuck over it. That's all I got to really say about it. I hope I, you know, changed some viewpoints. I know I've pissed off some nostalgia nerds. It's all fine and dandy. Dislike the video. I don't care. It doesn't hurt my feelings. Just lets me know that you're still a little bitch. And I'll catch you guys around.